Has anyone ever received a loan amount higher than your remaining entitlement? Okay. For instance, we purchased our first home at $173,000 in 2010. Since then, we have moved, but we have rented that home out for the last 6 years. We're hoping to buy a new home using the VA home loan, but only have $215,000 in entitlement. All the homes in the area neighborhood are averaging $300,000, which is $50,000 over our remaining entitlement. So has anyone ever had the VA increase that amount? If not, how do you make up the difference with this?
Great question.
Really good question.
I'm going to ask John. I do believe they could request a one-time restoration of entitlement.
They could.
But would they have, they would have to refinance the previous property out of the VA into a conventional loan, right?
The one-time restoration would allow them to buy the new property, but if they ever wanted to use the program again, they would have to sell both properties.
So they don't have to refinance the other property into a conventional loan? No? Okay.
So it's a one-time deal.
It's a one-time deal.
Yeah, I mean,
it's one shot. But on the other hand, if say you want to keep the property, right, and you don't want to go through one-time restoration, and you have some money to put down, that's where the 25% calculation will go in.
Yep.
On the difference between the sales price and the new loan amount. So it's still easier.
Yeah, and I think it's important for that individual to ask the question to know that just because there's a difference between remaining entitlement and what you're loaning, that's not $50,000. So in other words, that example was, we're buying $300,000, I only have $250,000 left, my down payment would be $50,000. That's incorrect. It could be a very small down payment. It could be, depending on the county loan limits, mm-hmm. and where you're buying.
Sure.
An educated mortgage professional and that does VA on a regular basis could quickly, through the VA calculators, tell you what that down payment would be. I've seen it sometimes in certain, as low as like $1,500, $3,000. And so it all depends, but you'd have to definitely reach out to the VA Regional Loan Center. Could actually answer that question for you very quickly. One of the loan analysts over there, loan specialists, and or a good mortgage professional.
Yeah, and I think just based on this scenario, I think they'd be more pleasantly surprised with how little they would actually have to bring in as a down payment.
Yeah, I mean,
it's definitely worth a call.
Oh,
what we're saying is, if you're ever going through that scenario, call one of the regional loan centers or talk to your mortgage professional, and get that advice before you make a decision, because I think, you'll be pleasantly surprised with what you find out.
I would agree 100%.
All right, well, that's been another episode of Military Spouse Mondays. I'm Brian Burgess, and my special guests, Rick Van Court and John Bella III. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining, and we'll
appreciate
see you
it.
Next week.
Thank you.
Take care.